Advances in 3D technology have had a major impact in almost every walk of life, on everything from TVs to houses to cars. Until now, though, the medical fraternity has largely been sceptical. But that looks set to change after surgeons in Melbourne performed a world-first operation in which they used a 3D printer to save a man's cancer-riddled heel. Greg Hoy has the story.
He was an interesting choice as a world-first test case. Age 71, builder Len Chandler had survived prostate cancer, two knee replacements, and lost an eye on a building site before doctors told him he had a cancer-riddled heel and would have to lose his leg.
I think the wife was more upset than I was. She was crying, but I thought, well, you know, if I've got to do it, I'll do it.
Len Chandler's luck changed remarkably, however, when he was sent to see orthopaedic surgeon Professor Peter Chung of St Vincent's in Melbourne.
And then he sat at the computer there for about 3 minutes and never said a word, and I thought, what's going on? And he said, oh, I've got some mates in CSIRO. He said, I'll ring them. He said, we might be able to put a titanium foot in.
This piece in here, is that hollow or is that just solid?
With the help of Melbourne technologists Anatomics, the CSIRO set about hurriedly building an intricate replica of Len Chandler's ankle bone out of titanium by using a 3D printer.
We had to make something that was not too heavy. It sits in a very precarious position that unites a number of joints in the foot. We also had to make sure that it was designed in such a way that we could suture to it some ligaments that exist around the ankle and foot to give it the sort of stability it
needs. Straight onto the metal.
Correct.
Well, it began on a Monday, and by Thursday we delivered the, quote, semi-finished final version to Anatomics. They did the preparatory work on it, sterilized it, and provided it to Dr. Chung on Friday for the operation.
It's now 14 weeks since the surgery. Both the patient and surgeon are delighted with the results.
And I think it's not hurting, so why? You've got to feel your way the same as anything else.
Do this for me. That's it. Good. Well, the surgery went very well. Excellent. There were no issues related to this. His progress has been excellent.
Another day, another milestone in the remarkable advance of 3D printing, where the future is limited only, it seems, by the imagination of experts.
3D printing offers an amazing future for medicine. We have always been frustrated at getting something small enough, fine enough, using what has been a manufacturing process that has remained fairly stable for perhaps the last century or so.
The 3D revolution is advancing on multiple fronts. At an exhibition in Chicago this month, US company Local Motors unveiled its 3D printed car.
The thing that this lends most to is customizability, so you can get a car that really suits your needs.
Also in the US, they are now printing with living cell structures and are making great progress in the bid to print human organs complete with tiny blood vessels.
And we're creating ears in the project we're doing right now with the military to provide these kinds of structures to our injured warriors.
Across town from St Vincent's, meantime, at the RMIT Micro Nano Research Facility, scientists are using another revolutionary type of 3D printer to build objects so tiny they are invisible to the human eye.
What are we seeing here and on what scale?
So this is an example of a three-dimensionally printed prancing horse. The height of the structure is about 70 micrometres. Which is about half the thickness of a human hair.
Researchers are using this technology to develop micro robots like this that will travel through the blood system to clear blocked arteries and for targeted drug delivery. Amazingly, they are also researching new fabrics that deflect and manipulate light to make invisible clothing or objects.
A 3D printer will allow you to build structures which are invisible at different wavelengths into one composite material.
From invisible clothing to haute couture, today 3D printing is also shaking up the fashion world on the catwalks in Paris.
You can now print continuous surfaces without seams or without parts, and they're just gradients, almost like gradients of energy, only gradients of material.
This raises the prospect of people having their body scanned to order garments that are perfectly tailor-made with a 3D printer.
Obviously, it's taking designers to a new level of things that have never been done before, and it's just the beginning, so I think the imagination would make the limit, because, you know, it's endless possibilities.
Other advances abound. The next generation of NASA's space exploration vehicle has 70 unique 3D printed parts to maximise mobility. The Chinese are even developing huge 3D printers to build small houses.
We just don't know where it's going to end. And I think its impact is going to be so widespread that it's going to be very commonplace.
Greg Hoy with that report.